Previously on the Rachel Zoe Project. I'm pregnant and I'm at the busiest point in my career right now. The timing could not have been worse. What I can't figure out is the giving birth part. Like, I just want them to put me out and take him out.
You won't feel
anything.
When
you had a C-section, you're actually awake.
So this house has everything going for it, Roger.
This is ridiculous.
This is huge. We're renting this house. It's non-negotiable.
I will agree to do this, but let me tell you. It's gonna be a nightmare.
I swear to God, if I wasn't in your life, you guys wouldn't be divorced.
She has so much going on. She needs you, Joey.
Do a million new beginnings.
No, and we're gonna do so many.
Honestly, I'm coming. Drink.
So excited. Oh my God.
I feel like you got so much bigger than when I saw you in New York.
I did. He's growing a half a pound a week.
Oh my
God. Say hi to your nephew.
Hi.
Tell me.
It's gorgeous.
It's sick, right?
Yeah.
I'm kidding. Hi, Tizzy. Welcome to LA.
I'm so happy to be here.
So happy you're here.
The weather here is so nice.
I'm so happy Joey's moving here because the reality of it is we have a ton of stuff going on and... I don't know, he just kind of makes me laugh my way through it. I
swear to God, your titties are huge.
They are for what they
when
were,
you, like,
but I feel
bend down,
shaky.
I can't even believe that you have, like, cleavage.
I wish they were, like,
can I see them just in your birth year?
Oh, wow.
You never were afraid of that before.
Well, it's different now. I have boobs.
When it was just a nipple, you were, like, showing everybody. Rachel's energy while she's pregnant is really fascinating. I kind of think for the first time, she really feels like a sexy woman. You know how much the baby
I have this
already?
Whole... The baby now is, like, 3.5 pounds, and apparently it's a really big head.
Are you going to actually let it come out of your vag?
I mean, that's the plan. I don't know. I haven't figured it out. I'm really... That's a super scary
vibe. I can see you're getting antsy and freaking
out. I'm super scary.
Are you going to let Roger be in the room?
Yeah. But I'm having Pammy come later this week. To be honest, she's coming because she feels really guilty. She's like, how's my nephew? I'm like, well, like, you would know. You haven't seen him in, like, 3 months. My sister Pamela's coming to visit... She knows everything about being a mother and having babies, and I know Jack. So hopefully she'll kind of give me the ins and outs a little bit.
Can I, like, hear it?
Yeah. Oh, my God, he's moving right now.
Let me hear him.
Wait.
I never thought in a million years I'd be laying in your bed with my ear to your stomach.
I didn't either.
All right, Jeremiah.
Beautiful.
Yeah. I must say, we got pretty lucky hiring Jeremiah as a stylist, because we also got an interior designer, no extra charge.
And we'll take a walk around, but I mean, this is over 7,000 square feet. I mean, what do you think for,
Well, I mean, when are you guys thinking about moving in?
Then we need to be here in 2 weeks. I'm serious. We need it completely furnished.
Okay. Never mind the fact that it's 7,000 square feet and you have no furniture. The lead time, expediting things, to getting in here quickly.
Can you just go to, like, a couple furniture stores and figure it out? Seriously.
Well, first of all, floor, no. It doesn't work. It's not that easy.
If you can't do that, though, Rachel's gonna freaking flip out. So, I mean, it's not me. I mean, listen, I could live, like, on freaking crates for a little while. I don't care.
When you think about over 7,000 square feet of house, they have, like, 3 pieces of furniture. 3. On top of it all, I have 10 days to do it. The staircase is bigger than my house. The entrance alone.
Wait till I see the master bedroom. Look how big this thing is.
It's enormous. We need to talk aesthetics. If she had her way, everything in here would be white, lacquered, and mirror.
I know.
She's like a gay man.
She is like a gay man.
I'm going to definitely try to push your guys' boundaries with pieces that aren't necessarily specific to your aesthetic. Like, you can have contemporary in here, but there's got to be some, like, traditional... pieces kind of mixed in.
I actually don't care how you're gonna figure it out. It's legitimately your problem.
Okay.
And you just have to deal with Rachel.
By taking on this huge project of the house, it's an opportunity for me to make myself valuable in the company. It's the only way I'm gonna actually be able to keep this job that I actually really love.
Good luck, buddy. You have 2 weeks.
Okay.
He's due. I'm gonna grab a water. You look thirsty. You want one?
I'm always thirsty.
Do your ankles retain water?
No, not yet, but I think that's coming. I think the best is yet to come.
Do you feel a little cankly?
Not yet. I think this little man drinks all of it and doesn't leave any for me. Give me 4 more weeks, and I swear I'm gonna, like, roll right out of here. I'm sure of it.
You're handling all this change really well. I feel like everything has changed.
It's also because I'm much calmer and the fact that I still have to decorate my entire house in, like, the next 2 weeks, potentially, because I won't have time to decorate it once I'm in there with a newborn.
How are you gonna do that? You only have enough furniture to do one room.
Well, 2 rooms, technically. Oh. 1 bedroom.
And one half living room
of a living room. But wait till you see the kitchen. This is like a real grown-up house. Like, it's massive.
Are you having someone decorate your house
for
you?
Well, yeah. Jeremiah, well, he's not Joey of all trades, but he's... Let's not get crazy. He has a great eye, from what I can tell. Okay, that's Jeremiah. Okay, I was going to give you a little bit of my opinion, but he interrupted, so I'll tell you the rest later. We'll gossip after.
Okay.
Honey, I'm home.
Come on in.
Were you here before?
No, it's my first time.
Oh, yeah. Welcome to Rachel's
White House. Hi, sweetie.
Welcome to Rachel's White House.
Hi, love. Hi. How are you? Jeremiah has great style, and I've seen his work as a designer. It's kind of my job to see when someone has a good eye. It's just a gut instinct that I have.
I'm having a manic attack inside about the house. The house
you're new, though, honey.
Okay, Jeremiah, we need to talk about this.
Yes.
I don't want to say it's a test.
It's like a test. You stay or you go kind of test.
It's not. But here's the thing. Like, I was trying to explain to Joey, I'm like, the funny thing is, at this point in my life, I just want people in my company that I like and that I like having around. So whether that's like...
So she's trying to tell you she hired you because you're cute.
No. No.
Take it.
I mean, cute helped, of course. But I know that you don't know my design aesthetic. Most importantly, what I don't like, I cannot stand clutter and kitsch. And I cannot deal with, like, I just, it needs to feel, like, open and airy.
Airy.
I want it almost like French modern. Yeah. And I don't even know if that's a word.
No, we'll make it a word.
I'm curious to see what you kind of, like, assess from seeing what I have here. I'm more of a neutral person.
Winter white. The whiter, the better.
Oh, I know.
But not
that's really old. Convenient with the baby coming.
I know.
Interior should be treated like a really great outfit. I mean, 100%. You have your classic, clean things that last you forever and are timeless, and then we can really funk it up, and we kind of blend the two styles with the accessories. The new house is super traditional.
Yeah, it is.
But it's going to be amazing, right. And it can come across as this Parisian parlor with, you know, still feeling warm.
Yeah. It sounds like something you would say in an interview.
But I do, just so you know, Jeremiah, everything has to be installed within the next, like, 2 weeks.
I can see how eager Jeremiah is to really get this done and really impress Rachel. So I hope for his sake that he could pull this off.
From this point, I'll take an inventory of everything you have.
Right.
And then we'll start working with a basic floor plan. We'll pull some samples and inspiration photos for you and go from there.
Okay.
All right, so my first project isn't exactly a stylist job, but I'm hoping to do a really good job so that Rachel feels confident in giving me an actual styling job.
I'm really glad I have a big job for you, because I also am actually going to need you on a bunch of my styling jobs, too, because we're super short staffed, too.
I'm ready.
Have fun. Don't mess up.
I'll try.
I want to make Rachel proud. I want to make Roger proud. I want to make myself proud. And I don't want to develop ulcers in the meantime. But I think it might just be a necessary side effect.
Okay, so I have, like, this amazing opportunity and this great shoot. And, like, you sort of already said you might do it.
Oh, my God.
The bad news is this shoot's in 24 hours.
What? Hi, Keish.
Hey, doll. How are you?
Just trying to figure out how to be 8 months pregnant and style 40 jobs in the next 2 weeks and then go into Oscars and then give birth somehow. Thoughts?
Okay, so I have, like, this really amazing opportunity and this great shoot, and I desperately need your help.
Oh, my God.
It's a promotion for Kim Kardashian. It's going to be a lot of fun. She's just, like, super, super excited about the opportunity of being able to work with you.
She's such a sweetheart. I saw her over the summer. She's a doll.
I sort of already said you might do it.
Keish.
I know. That's why I said it was a huge
favor. Oh, my God.
The bad news is that the shoot's in 24 hours.
What?
Yeah.
So I basically have, like, a half a day to get this together.
Yeah. And the premise is that there are different ways you can celebrate Valentine's Day. You can be sweet.
Mm-hmm.
And we envision that where she's wearing, like, a boyfriend pajama top, not a lot of makeup, really just natural and pretty.
Okay.
But then Valentine's Day can be sexy.
Right. So
then comes the sexy look. And that's sort of more of what Kim is traditionally known for.
Sure.
Lots of flowing, wavy hair.
Right. Keisha's a really good friend of mine, and I don't want to turn her down on this job, but, I mean, less than 24 hours is, like, almost impossible for a full-on photo shoot.
Will you send me size information, like shoes and everything, and location, just all those logistical details?
Absolutely, yeah.
All right, Keish, you're the best. I love you, and I hate you.
I love you. Thank you.
See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye. Seriously, the minute I get the sizing info from her, we're going to have to get all hands on deck and get going.
I seriously think I'm going to have Joey and Jeremiah do some polls on this.
I think you should.
God, Joey, pick up.
Hello?
Hey, Juju.
What's happening?
Can you grab Jeremiah and come to my condo? Because I just got booked on a job for tomorrow, and I literally need you guys to help me. So will you guys just come over, and I'll fill you in? I think you'll be excited. It's kind of your dream job.
Oh, my God, yeah. I'll be there in 15 minutes.
Bye, love. I love that he's, like, dropping whatever I'm doing.
Well, you know, I moved him to L.A., like, under the premise that, like, he's basically doing everything.
Yeah. So he's like, I'm on it. He's like Batman.
I love the fact that I was just, like, completely bitching and moaning that I have too many jobs in the next 2 weeks, and tomorrow was actually a free day, and now I took him another job.
Roger's gonna freak out.
I know.
Me. We have a 911 meeting. I'm coming to pick you up. I'm in your neighborhood. I'll be there in 5 minutes. Are you ready?
What?
When Rachel calls and says, come over, I don't ever ask any questions. I just know it's going to be something really exciting and juicy.
I thought you were joking.
Why aren't you ready?
Because you just called me.
When do I ever sound like I'm joking?
Stop. Can you come in for a second?
Can you hurry up and get ready? I told you
honestly,
you had 5 minutes.
Honestly, you called me 10 seconds ago.
We have to be at Rachel's house in 10 minutes. Why aren't you getting ready?
I'm just trying to figure out what's going on. I mean, I'm not even...
Just throw that on. Hurry up.
Joey's just one of those personalities that likes to f*** with people. And I am no exception, being the new guy on the block.
Can you wear shoes that don't take 5 hours to tie?
You're in a really good mood today, huh?
I'm just in a hurry. Let's go.
I'm literally tying my shoelace. Yeah. You good?
I hate this outfit. It's your fault.
Wow.
How are you, love?
Hi. Remember how I said if you come to LA, I'm literally using you for everything?
Yeah. Hi. You're taking me up on that offer now?
You look really cute, just saying. So, here's the thing, you guys. Big shoot with Kim Kardashian tomorrow to promote her fragrance.
I'm so excited.
Joey loves her. I'm going to send you to Bismarck. I want you to get Ryan Atwood's shoes.
Is it concept?
Yeah. Concept. Basically, one is the glamorous look, so she's gonna wear like a long, beautiful, sexy gown. And then the sweet one, which is basically her at home, and I want options like washed out white t-shirts and denim cutoffs, layered over a pretty bra, maybe sweatshirts off the shoulder, like a little flash dancey, and white button-up men's shirts, almost like she's wearing her boyfriend's shirt, something really sexy like that. So Joey knows what I would pull with my eyes closed, so Jeremiah followed his lead on that. And I'm not gonna have time to edit tonight. So I'm just gonna see everything on set tomorrow. So just overpull.
Obviously.
Just accentuate her beauty and her body and her curves and all that and just like work that. Hey, Jord.
Hey. How are you?
I'm good. Please don't hate me. The shoot is so last minute. I kind of need everyone to do everything. I'm having Jordan pull clothes for Kim, but I need Joey and Jeremiah to kind of rally and go deal with accessories. The dresses need to be super tight.
Okay.
So I think like Alaya, Zach, you know, those kind of body con designers. I feel like Zach would be amazing. All right?
All right.
Thanks, Jordan.
Okay, bye.
I think the shoot's going to be beautiful. But because it's in a house location, they want me to keep my team super, super tight. So I can only take one of you. I don't know who that's going to be yet. I'll let you know later.
I think I'm going to get this Kim Kardashian job. I feel really confident. But who knows?
I mean, it's a no-brainer to me. I know she's taking me.
Oh, my God. We have so much to do.
Go. Go.
Bye.
All right.
I love you.
Go. Love you, too. Bye.
I'm excited. No time for kisses.
Okay. I think it'll be fine. This will be good. Mm-hmm.
shouldn't be worried at all. Neither of them have ever filmed for me before.
I was just about to say, that was sarcasm.
Sure.
Hey, Jordan.
Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
So, what are we looking for?
We are looking for red dresses.
Okay. This is a beautiful red chiffon.
Yeah, this is great.
Then we could do the wool crepe skirt with a corset.
Oh, I love the corset.
And lastly, we have our red taffeta ball gown.
Great. If it's too much, we could just thin some of it out, too. Oh, that's perfect. Gorgeous. This is exactly what we're looking for. Great. Awesome.
And this is French silk satin.
I feel like she'll definitely go for the red more because It's more sexy.
This is very romantic.
That's great.
Actually.
Great.
This is a stunning couture gown.
This is perfect.
This is a halter style split strap.
That's great.
So when you walk, it just floats.
Perfect. Okay, great. And then someone will be here in an hour to pick up?
You got it.
All right, no thank problem. You.
Bye, Jordan.
Hi, honey. How are you?
Good.
This is Jeremiah.
Hi, Jeremiah.
Micah.
Nice to meet you.
This is going to be the first time I'm actually working directly with Joey, but I'm excited because Joey knows her very well and is able to translate things better than I think even Rachel is sometimes.
The concept is like Valentine's Day, like a gown that's really glamorous and black and red is kind of the color concept.
Okay.
And then they have her just lounging in her house with like an off-the-shoulder shirt, like giving it to you in her boyfriend's
dress
shirt.
You sure you don't want to do it? Don't give him any ideas. We're not here for that.
Right. She's like a 6.5, 7.
Oh.
Brian Atwood's art. Half the must have men.
We got Atwood's for date.
Oh my God. I need these. These for the gown are mage. Oh my God. Look at the red ones.
If we need to pull some other things on, just red and black. All we have is red.
The red is major.
We need the red. Wait, we have so many red shoes though. We have nothing else.
Oh my God. Did I pull these already?
Yeah, if it's red and black, you've pulled it.
Oh my God. Love that.
I hate them. But he's like pulling out the most ugly I've ever seen. He's being, you know, Zama. And I was realistically going, that's the ugliest thing in the world. We would never pick that up for a shoe.
Oh my God.
Joey, look at these.
I don't know if leopard is part of the story, but well, I mean, we could take one. Ugh. What else do you think?
Belts are cute, like over the button down.
I like these two.
Don't you feel like the belt needs to be a little bit more just simple?
No. Oh my God, I'm like falling apart in here.
We don't need to over accessorize with belts or anything. It's just clean and simple.
We hate to belt.
Super simple and clean, right?
Something I definitely learned about Rachel Zoe is that there is never enough options. I'm gonna take anything and everything I think she'll even look at. So, options, options, options. Why does anything have to make sense? It's fashion.
I can't. Take the bell if you want to take it.
Let's keep looking for stuff.
Although I think we should streamline the options that we're choosing so they make sense. I think we should have a ton of stuff.
With Rachel Zoe, there is no streamlining.
We ended up pulling everything. Again, I'm relying on the fact that Joey is her best friend and has known and worked with her forever. So, taking a step back, letting him lead the way.
More is more is more is more is more and not enough.
Oh, so excited to work with you.
Oh, me too. So fun.
You look amazing.
No, I don't.
From the back, you would never know you're pregnant.
Thanks, sweetie.
They're not gonna both do it, and then we're never gonna get the right count.
Hi, babe.
Hey.
I have a big job tomorrow in addition to the other 20 that I have, just saying.
What do you mean?
I have a huge job tomorrow with Kim Kardashian.
Nice.
It's to promote her fragrance. I actually pulled in Joey because he's obsessed with Kim and Jeremiah.
What? Do you have any shoots this weekend?
No, I hope not.
Want to arrange one?
Why would I want to arrange a shoot this weekend?
Because.
Why are you looking at me like
I mean,
that?
Did I tell you that I love you?
No. What? What are you hitting me with right now? No. The answer's no.
What do you mean? You
the answer's
know,
no. Yeah, I do. I already know where you're going with this. And no.
As you know, Sunday is the Super Bowl. I'm obviously going to be abandoning you for the day because I'm going to watch the Super Bowl.
Drinking a plethora of Bloody Marys.
There, see, we're totally in agreement so far.
Yeah. Where are you going with this?
Well, what I'm thinking about, or what my friends were thinking about, is she...
Going to Vegas or something?
How did you know, honey?
It's not happening. You're not leaving. Don't even think about it.
No. I'm totally going.
Oh, so you were asking me if I wanted to do a shoot so that I could be occupied?
I was just seeing if you were. It wasn't really, honey.
You are so selfish.
I'm not selfish.
I'm like 8 months pregnant. I can barely drive.
giving. You're like going to Vegas.
See, you're already committing to the fact that I am playing. No, no, the idea. Listen, and I really think that I've thought about it long and hard.
Really? And what's your rationale behind this?
You know, I've been cranky lately, and I think that the crankiness may stem from the fact that I feel like there's a lot of change that are going to happen, and I'm not understanding how to deal with
all of it. I'm sorry, the answer is no.
I'm totally not.
We have too much going on, love.
Just for a day?
No.
What do you mean no?
No.
What do you mean no?
That's the rudest thing ever.
Why is it rude?
Have I taken a girl's trip?
I encourage you to take a girl's
trip. But I don't like girl's trips. I like trips with you.
Well, that's unfortunate for you.
I'm
you
just have a better wife than you are a husband.
If that's what you think, I'm willing to accept that.
You have 24 hours to go to Vegas.
24 hours. It'll be like The Hangover, honey.
No, like, it better not be like The Hangover.
Oh, that's about to be bad.
But I'm talking, if you leave on Saturday, you leave Saturday night, and you get home Sunday night.
Totally.
Do you understand? This is a stupid conversation.
Why?
Because we're going to agree to disagree.
Great.
I don't think you should go. I think you're a jerk for asking, but you can go.
Sweet. Is there anything I get for you right now?
No, I'm perfectly fine right now.
Okay, there's your... Bye-bye.
The picking the clothes part is so fun. The schlepping, not so fun.
Let's call her really quick.
Hello?
Hi, it's Joey and Jeremiah.
Hi, boys. How did it go?
I think really well. Micah was really helpful, and Jer and I picked a lot of really good Brian Atwood shoes, like tranny ones that the studio doesn't have. Your job is so much fun. I was, like, pulling everything like I was in a candy store.
Everything.
Yeah, they just went off after a while.
Proud of you, Rachel. You made the best decision you could have ever made possible.
I'm disappointed. I definitely wanted to be there. I wanted to help. But it's not time. So, baby steps.
Hey, Jeremiah,
are
you
with
us?
Okay. Hi. Alright, take care.
I love you. I'll see you in the morning, babe.
Bye.
I think she handled that well. Today, love.
I'm running on 3.5 hours of sleep, so I'm sort of on this adrenaline rush, which is usually when I do my best work anyway.
Oh, for sure.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I like woke up at 3 a.m. like,
oh my god, I'm styling today. It's my first day styling. I'm so excited.
I hope that Kim likes the clothes, because we don't really have time for her not to be happy.
That's...
We don't really have time to fill in the blanks right now.
No nonsense.
Well, no fitting and no prep time, no fitting before the shoot. No time to actually run out because we only basically have 4 hours of shoot time. The fact is, Joey dies for Kim Kardashian, so if he starts to act a little, like, cuckoo crazy, I'm gonna have to make him go home. Is this it?
Yeah.
Great, let's go.
You need help?
Just rolling out of the car. I look like a pimp.
Does that make me your hoe?
Hi, George. How's it going, girls?
Good.
We're shooting a video for Kim's new fragrance, and there are two looks, sweet and sexy. But with Kim, even sweet is sexy.
Oh, this is a good one. Oh, Kiki, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Such a good one.
Yeah.
Kind of like soft and like, you know why? Because Kiki, it's like literally, this is what?
It's sexy men's shirt. Yeah. That's really good.
It's kind of funny.
And it'll fit a woman's body really
exactly.
Nice.
That's really chic, too.
You are right.
That's really chic, too.
Especially a busty woman.
Do we have hot pants and stuff? Like little, like, Cosabella, like...
Yeah, all the lingerie like over here.
For, like, under this? Like, you know, like, the, just the kind that, like, this sort of thing? But do we have maybe in, like, black or white
solids? I mean, we have a tub of underwear, so...
Okay. I like totally. These. They look like shower loofahs.
Yeah.
Sexy time.
Like with these, I think, maybe?
Could you do it with these?
Or there's some, like, lacy ones down there.
Great. I'm gonna go get some fresh air and go say a quick hi to Kim. Good morning.
Hi.
Good morning. Hi, pretty girl.
Nice to meet you.
Look, how are you?
I'm so excited to work with you.
Oh, me too. So fun.
I can't believe we've never worked together.
I know. It's kind of weird because I feel like I've known you for 100 years.
I know. You look amazing.
No, I don't.
No, seriously.
I mean...
Like, from the back, you would never know you're pregnant. I'm going to be like a whale.
You are not going to be a whale. No, you're not.
How?
No, you're not.
It's okay. No, you're not. Because you know what? You're such a workaholic. Like, I'm telling you, the reason that I didn't gain everywhere else is because I haven't sat down since I've
got pregnant. Yeah, you're, like, on the go.
But you're going to be the same. You're not just going to lie around and eat.
Well, you look amazing. Oh,
thanks, sweetie.
I'm excited.
When you're done, come in. We'll get clothes, and I can just run through the looks.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
What's it do? I mean, I'm just crunched on time, so what's the... What does it take to actually...
You have, what, 4 hours to shoot everything?
I think
not even.
Yeah.
For me, I can do it in 10 minutes. I think we do this with a little pair of, like, boy shorts underneath it.
That's great.
Great, and we just do a great bra underneath and, like, done. Okay, so, babes, we're going to start you in your sweet look.
Okay.
Which is this gorgeous Kiki Montparnasse shirt, which you're going to, like, live in. Wearing a white men's shirt and boy shorts is one of the coolest ways to look subtly sexy. You want to unbutton the top two buttons, wear a pretty bra underneath. You wear boy shorts because it's, like, more than underwear, but you're not wearing pants, and it's just kind of effortless sexy. So windy, so embarrassingly out of breath. We only have a few hours for today's shoot, and thank God, because I'm already completely wiped out.
Kim, are you ready?
Yes, she's ready. How's she gonna be sitting?
Yeah, like that. That's the move right there. It looks good, Rachel.
Yeah, okay. Hey, just you?
Yeah, honey.
I just need a clamp, maybe.
A clamp?
Yeah.
I'm gonna go grab one really quick.
Okay.
This shoot's a little different for me because I'm normally used to doing hair and makeup, which is a no-brainer.
Thank you, sweetie.
Here. But because I'm helping Rachel out with styling, I just want to make sure that I'm doing a good job and, you know, bringing a good energy and making it really fun to try on the clothes.
Her legs look amazing.
And your boobs are to die for.
Oh, my God. Rachel wants titties now.
You should buy them later. No, for real.
I can't. It's too high maintenance.
How's that look, you guys?
Fix the under leg. But, Joey, I like seeing the boy short.
Okay.
A little.
My God. Feeling up Kim Kardashian.
Clamp the waist.
Go for it. Hair, makeup, stylist, extraordinaire.
Just giving it to you, honey. High five.
In order to be a successful stylist, you have to be relaxed. You can't be starstruck or affected around the client. And Kim not only has to look good, but she has to feel really good. And I think Joey has that kind of gift to kind of make girls feel pretty all the time. Answer the phone. Babe, where are you? Call me when you get this. Bye. Babe, it's me. Again. I'm not calling you again. I love that Roger's not picking up the phone. For all he knows, I could be in labor right now. And he's planning a trip to Vegas. Seriously?
Hi.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Oh, my God.
Good stuff.
I've got a project that needs to be completed in 3 or 4 days.
Okay.
The client, Rachel Zoe, is a huge fan of your guys'.
Mm-hmm.
So she referred
me
to you.
We've made things for her before.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to come up with some really special pieces.
Okay.
Do you guys do custom case
and
stuff?
Yeah. Anything you see here can be customized in what a fabric she might want. And we can also get
you have fabric options to choose from?
Mm-hmm.
I'm in love with you. Even though the project she's giving me isn't styling, I'm excited to actually have something to do. And I'm hoping I do a really good job designing Rachel and Roger's home so she feels more comfortable to actually give me a styling job. Rachel and Roger's style is white and shiny.
Mm-hmm.
Like anything white and shiny. And
Her
if it's
body.
Got a mirror, mm-hmm. then she's like a gay man.
So possibly like our Sinatra sofa. So this one's in a navy velvet, but we would do it in like a linen.
Is there possible to do these nail heads as individual?
Yeah, no problem. It would be an additional $350.
Of course. But I mean, I know she's going to want to do like a lighter linen.
Okay.
So I think it would really stand out and be really strong.
Yeah.
Leah, oh my God, there's so many options. So any of these can be done in that time?
Yes, any of these can be done in that time.
And we'll start going
there's
through these.
There's ones in here. So
we have to stay away from like any leathers or velvets because it's going to look like an 80s porn if we don't.
Okay.
This is pretty. Oh, that's pretty.
Mm-hmm. I thought that one was a good one, too.
Yeah, I like that. I like the texture of that.
Yeah, see, like, this is beautiful.
It's got, like, a nice iridescence
mm-hmm.
or something to
yeah.
it. And let's get this sample.
Okay.
This is pretty.
And you want to sample this one, right?
Yes, do that
okay.
one.
Okay.
See, like, I love this.
Yeah.
This, the texture or something.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
There.
Perfect. So let's do those four.
Perfect.
But I'm going to be honest with you.
Mm-hmm.
I know that she's going to love
that
this
one right there.
I mean, she just is. And I'm doing these vintage chairs that are in there and like a really like pretty, I mean, she'll love that one.
Okay. It's a good one. We use it in all different colors.
Rachel's going to love the sofa. It's perfect. And it's white. On white. On white. She'll love it. Let's start with the production of that and
okay.
then I know she's going to want that one.
Okay.
Good.
perfect.
And if she doesn't, I'll probably really go applying for a job here next week.
Oh my God. You look absolutely bananas.
How much longer? Because we're running out of time.
5 minutes.
Kim.
We just got her.
Keisha's saying fire under your ass, hurry up.
Oh my God.
He's trying to be nice about it.
Hey, Keish, why do our 42-year-old husbands think that they reserve the right to go to Las Vegas on Sunday?
I got an email like an hour ago.
Keisha's husband is Roger's best friend. They've been planning this Vegas trip forever, and honestly, I don't like it at all.
But your husband's
the
man.
I'm the one that's pregnant and uncomfortable and working my ass off. Why does he get rewarded?
Because he works really hard for your company and works really hard to be a great husband.
What if she goes into labor?
That's what I said. I said, you shouldn't be leaving me right now. I'm almost full term. I said, if he wants to buy me a gift at Kraft Diamonds, that's totally fine.
Oh, so Vegas is okay if he buys you something?
100%.
You're disgusting. Your husband needs a bachelor party before this baby.
Joey,
don't be uptight, bitches. Let them have fun.
We are uptight, bitches. This definitely screams Valentine's Day.
Mm-hmm.
Sexy. The last look is sexy, and I want Kim to be in something that's super body conscious.
Happy Valentine's Day.
She has such a kick-ass body. I just feel like, show it.
Wow.
Super gowny gown.
Ooh. Yeah.
This might be, like, super tight, like, in the body, which would be great.
I love the bottom.
That's
amazing.
Great, huh? All right, let's, that is special edition.
You don't have to uncover it.
Do we have
sunblock? Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yep. Toast.
Going into the bathroom with Kim Kardashian and be back. Bye.
Let me see. Careful, lady.
Look at her.
Oh, my God.
Look
oh,
at you,
Mama. My God. You look absolutely bananas. The Dolce & Gabbana dress is sort of the answer to our prayers right now because it's super tight. It has that really low neckline with a halter strap. So it's like classy sexy. If I had to design a dress to wear on Valentine's Day with your boyfriend when you're trying to be like a little sultry, I would say it's kind of perfect.
Hey, Kim, hold on. Before you sit, I have to go up your dress.
Get in there.
I think I just got cracked. What do you think?
It looks really good.
Okay.
Hi. So I've been thinking, and what I said before, I had it all wrong. Cuddling at home is fine, but you can do that any old night.
Kim, just give me a few looks into the camera. Look away, look into it. Toss your hair around a little. But.
Great.
Thank you.
Zach, you got that full length, right?
Yeah.
Did you? Okay.
Oh, my God. This day has been so amazing. It really has been a dream come true, and I kind of have so much fun dressing her up because it's kind of like a voluptuous, sexy Barbie.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh, honey, I had so much fun.
You did a great job.
You are gorgeous. This was just fun. This is just
so
adding to it all.
I love it.
The shoot went amazing. It was super fast and really fun. Kim, love the clothes.
I love to see you.
Oh my God, something tells me I will see you before this is
tomorrow. Okay, I hope so.
Bye, sweetheart. I'm just the luckiest girl at the best team in the world. I couldn't actually be pregnant without my team.
It's a wrap. How'd I do?
You did awesome, Joey.
Yeah.
You really did awesome.
Thanks.
Like, I'm not even kidding. You really, like, were awesome. You were right up in there. You were, like, on every crease and every wrinkle, as neurotic as I am.
And the client liked me.
Well, I knew that. That was part of why you came on the shoot today. You really did awesome. I do not feel like this was your first time on a shoot with me. I mean, you just have no idea how hard it is to get ready.
Jesus Christ.
I can't get dressed anymore. It takes me like 10 hours.
Let me call you back. My wife just walked in with like a full-on, like, fur.
After a long shoot, the last thing I want to do is socialize, but Pam's coming, so I'm excited. I'm wearing what I'm wearing, and it doesn't matter if we're going to a diner or we're going to a fancy dinner. I can't get dressed anymore. I don't want to hear anything. Don't make fun of me. I'm so exhausted.
Where are we going?
My sister's on her way here. I have no idea.
I know. Did she land yet?
Yeah, she should be here any second.
Can you look at me when you're...
I just finished getting dressed, and then...
I want to look at your beautiful eyes. Yes, darling, you're talking to me.
Hi, Peony.
Hello.
Roger's been like a moody bitch lately. Thank God my sister's coming because she's going to take him out for dinner and a good meal usually cheers him up.
Where are we going and what are we doing?
Well, remember when we were talking about how you're like worried about everything and you haven't had any time to focus on this baby? So we're going to see a doula.
What?
I'm not even totally sure what that is, what to is be it totally about? Honest.
Well, she's like an expert in, like, educating about childbirth, assisting with childbirth.
What does it matter?
Because Rachel doesn't... Yeah, but they kind of, like, help the whole process.
I actually don't really want to know. I just want to wing it. I just want to go in there and have the
baby. I understand, but do I have to go? Like, no.
Yeah, you need to know what's going on here, okay?
You don't just show up. My pregnancy plan, I don't really have one. I'm just kind of winging it like I do everything else in my life. You're cool with this?
No, I'm not cool with it, but I mean, what am I supposed to do?
Right? You're
you
cool
really
with this?
This woman?
Yeah, I'm wearing this. I'm not changing, so I'm ready to go.
What does your outfit have to do with anything?
I'm just saying, I'm ready to go. And I look ridiculous. I don't care if I look like a hooker going to a doula. Let's
that
go.
Is what I was going to say. We got to go.
Let's do a lot. Me and Big Mama love each other.
Yeah, I don't want to be Big Mama.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Anna.
Hi, Rachel.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet
Thank
you, too.
Thank you for coming by. So how are you feeling? How is your pregnancy going?
I've been really lucky. I mean, I'm 8 months now, so I'm kind of like,
oh, you look amazing.
You know, thank you.
Can we back up for a second?
Sure.
Is it possible that you could explain exactly what a doula is?
She was asking some questions.
Yeah, I understand, but I'm just trying to understand the context.
Okay, absolutely. Yeah, well, she was just asking me how my pregnancy was. Is that cool?
I see why she's in the middle.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I'm a mediator.
So a doula provides information and support for pregnant couples. We do some of the early labor at home, and then when it's time to go to the hospital, we all go together.
Is there a reason to have a doula if you're having a C-section?
Yeah. People usually think that having a doula means that you're going to have a natural childbirth, and it's not at all. I've had two cesareans and then two vaginal births, so, you know.
That's called a VBAC.
VBAC.
Yes.
See?
Yes.
Wow, you know.
Oh, I know. That's why I brought them here.
Well, thank you for doing that.
In my opinion, it's such a scam. So I just want a normal, nice doctor that cares.
I have no idea what's going on with my husband lately, but I would swear that he actually got my pregnancy hormones, and he's just been a total nightmare.
I know you guys making plans, so how are you going to adjust your busy schedule to accommodate a little balance in between now and the time you give birth?
That's why I'm here.
Between now and
give
birth?
Are you going to be here all the way?
I'm going to come. No, I'm just going to come back and forth as much as I can.
Oh, we really don't have a plan.
Can you tell them a little bit more about the options of their birth?
Right, yeah. So what would be your ideal birth?
Push it out in 10 minutes.
So you would like to have a vaginal birth?
Yes. Would I like to? No. I'd like for him to just appear. I think how this child comes out should be the least painful, least traumatic.
Right.
I don't need to faint.
Do you even know what it feels like to have a contraction? I mean, do you even know what you're supposed to do? Like,
I had one, I just didn't know it. At a Braxton Hicks.
Oh, well, okay.
Right?
Is that what it's called?
That's exactly what it's called.
So, Rachel, is there anything about the pregnancy that you would like that Roger would be doing differently or not doing?
He needs to change his tone.
He's been a little crazy lately. I think he's trying to absorb some of her pressure, and there's so much going on that he's just trying to take it all and not put it on
this
her.
This is how marriage counseling is going to be.
Yes, exactly.
The baby's born.
We do us really well. We've been a couple for 20 years.
That's fantastic.
Now, as she's getting larger, some of the rational thought has escaped her recently. Rachel is a very controlling person, and when you try and offload some of the pressure, she feels the need to get involved on some level, which either...
I don't like surprises.
Which either A, mucks up the works of what you've done, and B...
Or
is
lights a fire under your ass to get things done.
Or B, is a little belittling, as if you can't handle it.
Not belittling.
Why am I even here? I'm not allowed to say anything. I'm not allowed to ask any questions. Rachel keeps cutting me off. So it's sort of like, honestly, I could have phoned this one in.
Bye.
Well, and you're lucky to have each other.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Yes, absolutely.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
Thank you.
Bye. I don't think anyone understands the amount of crap I'm dealing with for this company.
Excuse me.
So, you guys, can you tell me what you thought after all that complaining and bitching?
The reality of it is, you guys, I've always managed to do my best when I wing things.
This is probably not the best time to start winging.
Yeah. Listen, women since the beginning of time have been pushing babies out, so without classes. And I think we just know what to do. I'm going to get freaked out. If I start watching videos, I will literally not give birth.
Well, I don't understand. There's no argument here. What's driving me crazy is the fact that you're 8 months pregnant, but you're still trying to micromanage a business.
Excuse me. It is still my name on the door, and I do have a very big input in big decisions with the company.
What I'm saying to you, Miss Control Freak, is you need to let people do their jobs.
I do.
You know, because
yeah, I do.
If you want to stay a small little company where we run around and you're involved in every single decision and micromanaging everything, guess what? I'm not the right person
to be heading this company.
What does this have to do with anything?
That is my frustration. I don't think anyone understands the amount of crap and things and whatever I'm dealing with on a daily basis, but you have to trust that I'm doing things the right way.
But if it's something that involves me and I have a strong...
Everything involves
that's
you.
Not true.
At the end of the day.
Okay, fine. But if it's something that I have a very strong opinion on, I'm entitled to voice it.
Rachel's a control freak. She's always checking up and saying, hey, honey, did you do this? Hey, honey, what are they saying? I'm like, babe, I'm handling it.
The simple solution to this problem so that it doesn't keep going and you're not a cranky-ass bitch all the time is keep me in the loop.
You're copied on everything.
I'm copied
you're
on
like,
everything.
I didn't know that.
You know what?
I didn't know
you
that.
You know what?
I'm like, you're copied.
Just swallow your ego for 1 second and just say, babe, I'm going to just loop you in at halfway points so we can discuss it.
I will promise to keep you more in the loop, even though I already do. If you promise that you focus when people are talking to you, like I just had a bad day, just focus.
Okay.
Focus.
Deal.
That's all you gotta do.
Rachel Zoe Project.
Vegas up, bitch.
Vegas, baby.
You're really not mad that Roger's gone?
No. Roger genuinely hates lap dances.
Yeah, Rog.
Oof. He's all hung over and I have like a full-on photo shoot. This next 2 weeks is really, really slammed. Well, it's Oscar week and we're moving you.
The homeowners are going to be here in less than an hour and you guys have all of the furniture.
I'm glad this is not my problem, but I'm scared for you.
Thanks.
I cannot believe this is my house. I was not happy. I mean, I'm just... To learn more about the Rachel Zoe Project, go to bravotv.com.